I'm going to have to take a few more of your seeds, but I promise this is the last time. Let's go. As expected, no one here. My parents are in the throne room ruling the lands. Or rather, Mother is. There were reeds and water lilies growing in the pond. Naturally, they were planted there. They don't grow in the wild so high up the mountains. I can't think of any use for a water lily, but a reed could come in handy. A fairly small, unattractive tree.
Huh. I'd like to see how attractive you'd look if someone disturbed you on the pot in the morning.
You mean...
Anyway, what can I do for you, my little beauty?
Mother put me on a diet this morning so that I'll look perfect for my wedding.
Oh, everything has to be perfect for her. No such thing in nature, of course. Or rather, everything is perfect if you just let nature run its course.
You tell that to Mother.
I have, many times. She'd be very clever in some things, but very daft concerning that.
Now then, she is the queen.
I'm old enough to be able to call a spade a spade. Spade, gardener. Get it?
You and Father, you get along well, don't you?
No one understands more about nature than him, that's for sure. But I don't often ask him for help. Thinking has never got a field dug, if you get my drift.
He's just more of a theorist.
The mud on your feet, the smell of fresh earth, all that joy and life. And he's missing out on the lot by just sitting around up there and doing nubbit.
The garden always looks fantastic, Arbor.
Thank you. It's a girt load of work. People always think elf gardens are fabulous by their very nature. But you need a mighty good gardener.
You have got green fingers.
That's just moss, my dear. Happens if you spend all day grubbing around in the earth and don't wash your hands properly in the evenings.
What are you up to today, then? Got much on?
Oh, the usual. You know, it never rains in the elf burrow, but the flowers need their water, so I water them every day.
The curse of good weather.
The weather isn't the only thing which isn't right. We've been here 30 years, and for 30 years we've had autumn.
Time passes differently in the elf burrow. Slower.
Well, that's why everyone grows to be ancient here, obviously. But if we had a bit of normal weather and the usual seasons, there'd be a lot more variety here.
Nowhere are the trees so green and healthy as here in the elf world. You tree shepherds do a great job.
Tree shepherds? The trees just stand there. What do they need a shepherd? However, I quite fancy one of those shepherd dogs. Hey, Rex, do you want to be my shepherd dog? Nah, my darling. I'm a gardener. Nothing more, nothing less.
I have to get on.
Yep, got a bit to do myself. I just don't know what's wrong with that plant over there.
This flower clearly is one of the more exotic of the palace's flowers. It comes from a country in the deep south beyond the deserts. It's said that the flower of this plant used to be sent as a declaration of war, or if one wanted to deprive someone of all sense. Why do so many people hate this flower? Perhaps it has an abhorrent smell. Now that explains why this flower is classified as a weapon in 24 countries. This plant reminds me of the one that Arbor's having problems with at the moment. Love Lily. The love lily enters into an enduring relationship with another plant very early in its life, which frequently lasts its lifetime. If the partner plant dies, then the love lily does not normally survive the separation. What have we got here then? Aha! Ah! Almanac of Elf Medicine. That's what I've been looking for. Perhaps there are a few practical hints and tips in the fishing book. Arbor's pot, literally. I really shouldn't. Ugh, it's only earth. I should tell Mother how her daughter. Well, she'd be delighted. A handy smooth stone, Arbor's sheepdog. I often see you fishing. Could you lend me your rod?
Of course, if you bring it back in one piece. What's up?
I was convinced that I would have to make my own fishing rod or that you'd ask me to collect a variety of mystical items in exchange for it.
Why? It's only a rod.
Thanks.
Well, everything needs to be complicated, you know.
Do we have a metis bush in the garden here?
Or that bush over yonder.
But that fruit's red.
And what colour do you expect then?
Green. Are they only green when they're not ripe?
Nah, they're blue then. They're green when the bush senses danger.
Pardon?
The metis bush has exceptionally delicious sweet fruit. But if it thinks it's in danger, then they go green and very sour. Call it a defence mechanism.
If the bush had a heart, it would have skipped a few beats. Thanks. Pity. Perhaps I have enough knowledge to now understand the book. Aha! Oh, twice in a row, then. That was educational. Pity. At last. Now I can take the red herring off my list. This flower was given to us by the fairies, just like the love lily down in the garden. I bet they belong together. These earrings here. They're sparkling and glinting in the sunshine. They could actually come in handy. I've got a flower here that could help you with your love lily.
And?
Yes, look! Look, do you know this flower?
Ha ha ha! You did well, girl.
It would appear so.
You snivelling girl. You all right?
Yes. I don't know.
Well then, I think I've earned myself a little rest now.
That's Arbor's little spade. He always leaves his stuff all over the garden, which of course drives Mother mad. The smoke from Arbor's pipe seems to be calming the bees. This is my chance.
Hey now, you all right there?
Sorry, had to do it.
Well, I'm not happy about this destruction of nature. Not unless I get half of that there honey.
I don't need any more. The rest is for you.
Mm. Oh, that'd be good stuff. But that's enough. The bees need a bit too.
Oh, that fruit smells really sour. Thanks for the sacrifice, little fish. About one spoon of honey. Water's the easiest thing. That should do it. The medicine book reckoned that it should be a viscous potion. I'm pretty sure that there's never been anything so utterly revolting concocted in the Elf Burrow ever. Oh, I hope this is some kind of joke.